This is Sky One.
In the first week of Sky One's brand new show, 1 to 3, these were just some of the highlights.
I'm going to give him a kiss.
Did you get the impression we're in a hurry?
Sarah, lap dancing, not tap dancing.
The bacon is divine.
Ben, I like the kinky boot show.
Sorry.
Join Sarah and Paul this week when their guests will include Clive James, Kim Wilde, and Martin Landau.
See you then.
See you then.
Catch 1 to 3 every weekday at 1 on Sky One.
Welcome to the March family.
The most elegant family in Concord.
May I present myself?
Join four sisters as they travel through life.
Bear our souls and tell the most appalling secrets.
And through love.
Why must we marry at all?
To womanhood.
You don't need scores of suitors. You only need one, if he's the right one.
Listen to the child.
Joe.
You have so many extraordinary gifts. How can you expect to lead an ordinary life?
Meg.
Nothing, of course, there.
Beth.
Feels so strange.
And Amy.
Waited my whole life to be kissed.
I promise to kiss you before you die.
Susan Sarandon, Gabriel Byrne, and Winona Ryder.
I could never love anyone as I love my sisters.
In a story cherished for generations.
Some books are so familiar, it's like being home again.
Little Women premieres Thursday on Sky Movies. City of San Francisco, full of crime, sex, and scandal.
Doesn't it drive you crazy?
Meet the man to clean it up.
My name is Nash Bridges.
There's something you should know about me. Sometimes, I lose my temper. It's time to get ugly.
Move over, Miami. Don Johnson is back.
Yeah.
In a brand new series.
Damn, this is gonna be fun.
Nash Bridges, Thursday at 9 on Sky One Primetime.
Personally, I can't wait.
Star. Well, Lisa Cool, Undertaker, Shawn Michaels, Heartbreaker, Bret Hart, show 'em how. Look, here comes a bad boy now. Ahmed Johnson's muscles huge, Hunter Helmsley's blood is blue. Psycho shit, a dangerous man, Bulldog Englishman. Check out the Lion King, Goldust is mighty strange. 1, 2, 3, bought and sold, backlunch campaign running.
Are you ready?
If the WWF title had a heck of a lot to do with you deciding to stay in the World Wrestling Federation?
You know, I'd love to say yeah, but it doesn't. You know, if I come back, even now, if I come back and I don't win the title and it turns out that I just do pretty darn good, I think I just want to come back without any kind of real, you know, I'm going to set my sights as high as I can. I really want to just come back and do the best that I can. I want people to go, there's a guy that gives 100%, and there's a guy that's honest, and there's a guy that has integrity, and that's a guy that doesn't sell out, and that's a guy that's tough. You know, I mean, all the other things, I mean, it all adds up into a lot of different things. But I mean, I'd be nice to win the title again. I mean, I'm going to try my hardest. I hope I don't disappoint anybody if I fail at that, you know. And maybe if that doesn't seem like it's in touch, maybe I'll go in search of trying to get the IC title then, you know. I mean, that's no small claim, you know. And then there's the tag team titles. Maybe if I could just win the King of the Ring, you know, maybe that'll be enough to say, hey, you know, I'm back, you know.
Royal Rumble's coming up.
Anything. I want to be a player. But how big a player I'm going to be, I mean, I'm no spring chicken anymore, and you know, if you can gauge anything off how Shawn Michaels did when I in the one match that I seem to have watched, the one with Mankind, you know, I had really stood back and went, this guy's gonna be tough, and there's Steve Austin is gonna be tough, and Vader is gonna be tough, Psycho Sid is gonna be, these guys are not gonna be, you know, they're stacked up. It's going to be a long, long haul. But the thing is, they got to take into account that Bret Hart's coming back. And it's like, oh, Bret Hart, you know, the best there is coming back.
Let's talk about Stone Cold Steve Austin in a few minutes. Here's a guy that I understand that your dad is a big fan of. I mean, I know he's a fan of him personally. I'm not saying that, but I understand that Stu enjoys watching Steve Austin compete. Is that true?
I'm sure. I mean, I'd have to. I don't know if to be true or not, but I'd have to say I concur with him. I mean, he would have to be. I know my dad likes guys like that can wrestle, and he'd be watching a Steve Austin.
And your dad likes tough guys.
He likes tough guys, and he likes guys that can take a lot of punishment. Steve Austin's a great wrestler. I mean, you know, he's a little. You know, his worst enemy would be his temper, probably. You know, but I watched him and. And I think he's a great technical wrestler, and very few wrestlers can come close to him right now. I mean, name one. You know, I don't know one. Shawn Michaels, you know, I think is a great wrestler, and he's a great athlete, maybe the best athlete in wrestling. I mean, he's really that good. But it's not just athletics. You know, it's one thing to be able to swing from a rope and run and jump and tumble and do whatever it is that you want to do as far as athleticism. But it comes right down to who can fight. How can you fight? And how tough can you handle it? Can you take a lot of punishment? And Sean can take a lot. But I don't think he's tough enough.
Regarding Austin, have you ever, in your mind, and all the great people that you've competed against, you know, you alluded to meeting Davey Boy in Wembley, you know, 83,000 fans. That match has been well documented. You've had some real physical matches where we talked about with Diesel, with... The Undertaker. The Undertaker match, I remember one match vividly that was about as intense as I ever saw. But as far as comparing Austin to anybody else you faced, how does he rank as far as just pure tough guys that you know going in, man, I'm going to pay the price in this one?
Oh, yeah. You know what? It kind of reminds me of me wrestling me a few years ago. And a lot of ways, he's got a lot on me. You know, he's real strong. You ever see his legs?
Yes.
Strong guy, tough guy, and he's a machine in there. But again, then you start finding faults with Steve Austin, you find that he's a guy that's capable of making mistakes, just like everyone is. But I believe that the one quality that I have over a Steve Austin, or anybody else actually, is that I don't make mistakes, or very rarely. And when I do, well, what happens is you lose a world title to a guy after an hour wrestling match when you have him beat and you have him on the ropes. That's when I lose, that's when I make a mistake. But I mean, it's not very often. And when I do make a mistake, you know, I come back to haunt them.